Okay, so in this video, I want to show you actually doing a recording in Screencastomatic. Previously, I gave you an overview of the recorder tools, but now let's go ahead and launch the screencast tool to do our first screencast. So it'll launch the recorder and it'll give us the bars that show me what's, the area being recorded. I'll go ahead and maximize that again so you can see those. Now, I already did the overview of this black panel of tools here that you've got options for. So be sure to see that video because I'm not going to go through each one of these again. But let me pull up in a different tab, or perhaps it's a Microsoft Word document, whatever it is that you want to record for your students. Maybe it's a PowerPoint slide. You're going to have that up on the screen. And notice that you've still got the black and white outline around what you're going to record. So now you're going to want to adjust that based on the content that you're recording. So you can drag and drop the handles in the corners along the sides so that the size is wherever you want it to be. Now you have to decide whether you're recording a screen, you're recording just the webcam and not the screen, or whether you're doing both. Actually, for this recording, I am going to do both. So I'll start with the webcam on, and then I'm going to turn off my webcam, which is how I'll show you how to do that in a second, and then I'll turn it back on in the end. Okay, so I've got my 15-minute time limit, I've got the screen size that's going to be recorded, and then also important to check is that the microphone is detecting your audio. So do some test, one, two, three, and make sure that you're getting green bars here that's detecting the audio through the mic. If you need to change that, you would select here and choose the appropriate microphone that you plan to use, and make sure that you are getting. You can do adjust the volume if you need to, and make sure that you're getting green bars here detecting your audio. So that's really important. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and close that. What I'm going to do, like I said, I'm going to start with a quick talking head. Hi, I'm Katie. Then I'm going to turn off my webcam, and I can do that by clicking on this little guy. And then I'll do the main part of my screencast, and then I'll come back and I'll do a little quick wrap up with my talking head again. This one puts my webcam in the center of the screen on top of most of the content. It's bigger. I'm going to keep myself down to the side here so that it doesn't cover up the content. You'll see what I mean. But you'll notice that I click over here and I click back in the midstream of my video. I'm going to hit record. It's going to count me down. I'll do the recording and then I'll hit pause when I'm done. You'll see. Okay, so here we go. Hi students, this is Katie Palacios. I'm your instructor this semester. I wanted to take a few moments just really quickly to show you the best way to contact me this semester. So in Blackboard, in our course menu along the left, you're going to see a link that says Contact Katie. When you click on that link, you're going to get this screen. You've got really two good options, two ways to contact me. One is to send me a message in Blackboard, and you can do that by clicking that first link. It opens up the Blackboard course messages tool, and you'll see a button that says Create Message. You can click on that button, look for my name, and send me a course message. The other way to contact me this semester is to call my Google Voice phone number. This is not my cell phone number. It's my Google Voice phone number, but it does forward to my cell phone. If I am available, I'll pick up and we can talk about whatever it is that you need. If I'm not available, you'll be able to leave me a voicemail, and then I can get back to you as soon as I can. I'll get back to you. Okay, so those are two good ways of contacting me should you have any questions for me this semester. Okay, best of luck to you this semester. I look forward to working with you, and I hope you feel comfortable, and now you know how to contact me with your questions. Okay, best of luck. Okay, so that went pretty smoothly. It wasn't perfect, but whatever. I'm just going to go with it. Okay, so notice I hit the pause button. It tells me I'm at 1 minute and 24 seconds. So I have some options here. Okay, I'm not recording right now, even though, well, I am recording, but it's in Camtasia. So if I wanted to continue recording, remember I hit the pause button when I finish. So I could pick up where I left off by just continue hitting this record button, and then I could continue my recording. I could play what I've got so far, so it would show me a little preview of what I've recorded so far. I could trash this completely, delete everything, and start over if I know it didn't go well and I wanted to try again. I'm done. I'm okay with this one. I'm gonna go ahead and hit the done button. Okay. And that's what I'm going to. So now I've got the option for publishing this video, and that's what I'm going to cover in our next video.